So we're behind the scenes, just a few hours away from the South Asian Spelling Bee getting started, and we're doing a roundtable discussion with our spellers to see exactly how they're feeling right before the competition.
Well, right now I'm just like praying that I do well.
I'm excited to see what words the wordsmiths are going to try to throw at me and try to get me out with.
Usually South Asian people win like this group spelling bee and other spelling bees, so it's interesting to be in a spelling bee with only South Asian people.
I feel like in some ways being a South Asian, it can encourage you to do better, and in other ways it can also be like you have to do well.
I kind of feel more motivated in a way that other South Asian kids are doing well, and I feel like I can too.
I've made some new friends today, like Dev and Arjun, and it's really fun making new friends because the pressure gets less and you get calmed down.
Any kind of last minute good luck charms or any kind of superstitions?
The color of one goddess is white, and she's the goddess of learning, so I always wear white.
I usually wear shirts with words like this one, like play under pressure or rise above the rest or something, just to get me motivated, and probably it'll mean good luck.
I like wearing my bow tie.
Wish you all the best of luck this evening. We're rooting for all of you, and do us proud.
Okay, are we ready to begin? Everybody, we have 12 spellers left going into round number four. We'll start round number four with speller number one. Zoizen. Zoizen.
Zoizen? Can I have the definition?
Zoizen is a white-crowned widgeon with a short, narrow bill that breeds in northwestern North America.
Zoizen. Z-O-I-S-E-N. Zoizen.
Yes, the correct spelling of Zoizen is Z-U-I-S-I-N. Horopito.
Horopito?
Horopito.
Horopito. Can I have the etymology, please?
Maori.
Horopito. H-O-R-A-P-I-D-O. Horopito.
I'm sorry, it's H-O-R-O-P-I-T-O.
Thank you.
Morbi. Morbi.
Morbi?
Morbi.
Morbi.
Yes.
Language of origin, please.
Unknown.
Mobby. M-A-U-B-E-Y. Mobby.
Correct.
Enamost. Enamost.
Can I add the part of speech?
Adverb.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Yes. Gramps said he was enamost tuckered out, and I knew he really needed a break from work. Enamost.
Enamost. E-E. N-A-M-O-S-T, enamost.
Correct.
Jacitara. Jacitara.
Jacitara?
Perfect.
Okay, language of origin, please.
Portuguese, who took it from Tupi.
Jacitara. Jacitara. J-A-C. I-T-A-R-A, Jacitara.
Correct.
Erfurness. Erfurness.
May I have the language of origin?
German.
May I have the word used in a sentence, please?
The museum at Corinth had a footed bowl reconstructed with some original pieces of Erfurness from a Neolithic era.
Erfurness. U-R-F-U-R-N-A-C-E, Erfurness. That's wrong.
Yeah, I'm sorry, it's U-R-F-I-R-N-I-S.
Thank you.
Aroe.
Definition, please.
Yes. Aroe is a wild sheep of North Africa.
Language of origin, please.
This is an African native name.
Could you please use it in a sentence?
Yes. The guide on our safari identified the wild sheep as an Aroe, but Dad called it a Udad, another type of sheep from North Africa.
Aroe. A-R-O-U-I. Aroe?
One letter too many. A-R-U-I.
Okay. Epicycloid. Epicycloid.
Epicycloid. May I please have it in a sentence?
Yes. The mathematician tried to describe an epicycloid, but Jen couldn't envision the relationship of the two circles.
Epicycloid.
Perfect.
E P I C Y C L O I D. Epicycloid.
Correct.
Go moody. Go moody.
Can I have the part of speech?
Noun.
Can you use the word in a sentence?
Yes. Black fiber at the base of a gomudi is much like horsehair, very strong and usable underwater.
Gomudi. Can you just say everything?
Sure. Gomudi is a noun, Malay. It's, and the definition is, a Malayan feather palm that has large leaves with the bases densely clothed with fibers used especially for marine cordage and cable. As a sentence, the black fiber at the base of a gomudi is much like horsehair, very strong and usable underwater.
Gomudi. G-O-M-O-O-T-Y. Gomudi.
I'm sorry, it's spelled G-O-M-U-T-I.
Thank you.
Calabrese. Calabrese.
Calabrese. Can you use it in a sentence?
Yes. A member of the col vegetables, calabrese is a type of broccoli with dark blue-green flower buds.
Can you repeat the word?
Yes. Calabrese.
Calabrese. Calabrese.
Calabrese.
Calabrese.
Perfect.
Calabrese. C-A-L-I-B. R-A-S-I, Calabrese?
I'm sorry, it's C-A-L-A-B-R-E-S-E.
Thank you.
So Tejas, tell me what your experience was like this evening. How are you feeling right at this moment?
Well, I'm kind of disappointed because most of the words in the round I knew, but I'm pretty happy and I'm ready to go back home and start studying again.
What do you think it is about this competition that you're already thinking about the next time?
Well, I kind of want to beat my place this year for next year, and I want to study more words so that it'll help me in the Scripps National Spelling Bee.
Exuvii. Exuvii.
Can I have the definition?
Exuvii is the natural covering of an animal as the skin of a snake after it's been sloughed off. Sorry.
Can I have the language of origin, please?
Yeah, Latin.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Yes. The biologist had a small collection of exuvii, and the most interesting was a very long snake skin remnant. Exuvii.
Exuvii. Am I pronouncing that correctly?
Perfectly.
Exuvii. E. X. U. V. I. A. E. Exuvii.
Correct.
Rick's dollar. Rick's dollar.
Rick's dollar. May I have the definition?
Rick's dollar is an old Swedish dollar similar to the German Reichsdollar and serving as the country's basic monetary unit from the 16th century to 1878.
Rick's dollar. May I have the language of origin?
Swedish, but they took it from Norse.
Rick's dollar. May I have the part of speech?
Noun.
Rick's dollar. R. I. K. S. D-A-L-E-R, Rick's dollar.
Correct.
And that completes round number 4. Let's have a nice big round of applause.
We are here with Jaideep Janakiram, the head of North America for Sony TV, who has actually been a partner and has broadcast the South Asian Spelling Bee for the last 7 years of its existence.
We felt that Spelling Bee is an amazing addition to our type of programming, which revolves around family, the parents, the children.
Are you biting your nails? Are you getting excited for rooting for them?
I had to go for a couple of other events. I'm still here. That shows that once you get involved in it, there's no walking away from it. So I enjoy it every year.